What a week. Big gains all across the board. We'll get to some specific stock picks in a minute, but our focus turns now to next week. And before we get back to the real deal squad, Mike Huckman is at the NASDAQ with a look ahead at the coming week ahead.
So the NASDAQ win streak stops at 12, but not after rising in the low double-digit percentage just over that short period of time. So what can start another rally here possibly? Well, next week, of course, we've got more earnings in tech, Symantec, in media, Barry Diller's Interactive Corp, and then in healthcare, a few big companies, including Amgen, Teva Pharmaceuticals, and Express Scripts.
All right, let's get back to the Bulls and the Bears and talk about picking some winners. Peter Schiff, Bureau Pacific Capital President. He's a kind of a bearish guy. Lee Munson, Portfolio Asset Management, CIO. He's a bullish guy. Mark Caller of Caller Financial, bear. John Buckingham of Al Frank Asset Management, bull. And Bill Sichel, with the Chief Investment Officer with Philadelphia Trust. Bill Sichel, why don't you start us off? Give us a couple of stocks to look at in the coming week.
Okay, it's Rich. Air products, we like. We like materials. We're overweighted there. Air products, DuPont companies like that. We like industrials. Honeywell's coming out with earnings on Monday. There could be some positive surprise. They have a nice dividend around 4%. The price to earnings growth ratio is relatively low. And you go over to tech. Intel's numbers were wonderful. Microsoft, very disappointing. So
strong second half outlook for Intel. Actually, Microsoft also has a strong second half outlook, doesn't it?
Yeah, but Intel, I mean, they had end user demand, which we haven't seen a lot of, it, rather than inventory building. And then Microsoft knocked things down. And, you know, tech needs to take a little break. But we like EMC, Cisco, even good old IBM. So you'll get some chances to get in maybe a little bit cheaper.
Yeah, I like tech, and I think corporate customers have a snapback in demand that's going to have to come into play at some point. Lee Munson, give us a stock or two.
You know, one thing I think that we're going to see in this recovery is that we're still going to have a high savings rate along with the recovery in the economy. So I like things like Amazon. I started buying it today on the big drop today because they're the Walmart of the Internet. They bought Zappos, which makes a lot of sense, and I think for the long term it's going
to
do well.
What does the high savings rate have to do with recommending Amazon? High savings Amazon. I understand. Amazon, you have to spend to buy books.
No, absolutely. It's a great question, Dennis, because what it really has to do with is that generally when, you know, these economies recover, you're going to look at things like Coach or Tiffany's and luxury goods. People start spending more discretionary dollars. And I think this economy can recover very well, and I think people are going to have more interest in buying more things at, say, Target stores or Amazon, and they're going to have more confidence spending. But I don't exactly think that we're going to see a lot of high-end spending as we did during some of these last bull cycles, like the dot-com or some of this juiced-up subprime spending.
All right. Hey,
does that make sense?
Okay, that does. Okay, Peter Schiff, I got a dare for you, babe. Find me one U.S. stock to buy, Peter. Give me one U.S. stock.
Newmont Mining.
All right, because of the gold thing.
I mean, most of the stocks I'm buying, nobody's heard of. But if you want to look at the U.S. market, you know, you want to focus on the exporters, the multinaturals, the resource companies, mining companies, oil and gas, agriculture.
Lots of sales overseas, right?
There's some foreign tech stocks that are good buys. But, you know, back to the U.S. market, you want to stay away from any company that depends on the U.S. consumer for their revenues. You don't want to invest in companies that are loaning money out to people who expect to get paid back. And you definitely want to stay out of the bond market.
Okay, John Buckingham, I'm hoping Peter Schiff is entirely wrong. Give us a recommendation or two.
Well, here in our Prudent Speculator newsletter, we're always focused on buying undervalued stocks that are inexpensive, trading at low valuations, low PE. So names today that are attractive would be things like a Super Value, which has really been crushed, yielding 5%, trading for 5x earnings. Chesapeake Energy, also been crushed in the natural gas space. Technology is an area we like as well. Synopsys with $6 a share in cash in the semiconductor area. And if you want kind of a counterplay, counter-cyclical, if you will, Cornell Companies, the prison operator, that stock has performed poorly here. And I think there's plenty of growth potential there.
I think prison is recession-proof. Okay, Mark Caller, I think you're wrapping it up for us here, so don't depress me. Give me some stuff to buy next week.
Dennis, I'd love to do that right now. We're getting ready to short the market. We are now 100% cash across the board for at least the 6 to 8 weeks from right now. We're looking right at the edge of the Grand Canyon, and my clients are 70 years old. They can't afford to lose anything, so we're just going to hold on for right now. Mark, and that goes short.
You're breaking my heart, Mark. You're breaking my heart.
They can't
Fredo.
Afford cash.
How
Happy
far
birthday,
down is it going 8 weeks, Mark? How
they
far
can't
down
afford
is it
cash.
Go?
My clients are old too.
They're going to outlive the dollar.
Right.
That's the problem.
Right. But who said my clients are old too? Who said that? Which guy?
Hey, my clients. That's me. It's me,
right.
Lee.
And you know,
my clients are mostly retired.
Can they, Lee?
All our clients are old.
No, because my clients spend their money.
Young people have no money.
They need money to spend.
If they're 70, they're going to
live. We give our clients money to spend.
If they're 70, they're going to live to 90, so they have long-term investors.
Right. Mark, this eight-week slaughter coming up that you're now staring at the brink of, how low does that Dow go, Mark?
About 2,800 at the worst.
Wait, it falls by 2,800 points?
Yep, over the next year to year and a half.
No, but in the next 8 weeks?
No. It could go sideways, Dennis. It could go to 11,000. It could backtrace just a little bit and then take
the pop. You took all your cash out.
Dennis, there's too much volatility and too much at risk for the seniors. That's our concern.
You got to worry about the cash. If you want to own cash, you should look at other currencies. You know, look at Singapore dollars, Swiss francs, look at yen, look at euros. Don't stay in U.S. dollars. It's not safe.
You know what? Big brands, blue chips, incredibly cheap. And I don't think this economy is falling off the cliff. Not anymore, anyway. Thank you so much, gentlemen, for being here.
Happy birthday, Dennis.
Happy birthday.
Thanks a lot. We'll see you next week.